Buongiorno. Good morning. My name is Julia Shamova. I'm the Director of Operations of UNETA, the European Network for Health Technology Assessment, and the UNETA Secretariat at the Danish Health and Medicines Authority in Copenhagen. So please, please come in, take your seats. Benvenuti a Roma! There is so much sun, fun, hospitality, good food that we are all becoming a little bit more Italians ourselves. So I think by the end of the second day, if we are not fluent in Italian, we will know a few words. Meraviglioso, fantastico, squadra di calcio. Speaking about teams, while we're waiting for the rest to join us, I would like to say that our team today is 450, about, people that are coming from all over Europe, both political Europe, European Union, and geographical Europe. And quite a few are coming from outside of the European continent. There are many backgrounds, many sectors are represented here today. We have health technology assessors, we have regulators, payers, we have representatives of the patient organizations, industry, healthcare providers. So I would say that we have a good starting point on our journey today and tomorrow to reach the goal of this conference. And the goal is discovering and learning together how to work across intellectual silos and any kind of silos for a greater value. So before I continue, I would like to say one thing. Why HTA 2.0 Europe teaming up for value? Several years ago, Steve Jobs, the founder of Apple, at one of the Apple events, declared, "Today, Apple reinvents the phone." And this morning, we say, "Today, Europe reinvents HTA." In the 70s and in the 80s, those who brought to life the concept of health technology assessment probably intuitively knew that what it means actually is multidisciplinary assessment of value. Interaction, collaboration, participations are in the origins of HTA. So you would say, what's new then? Why HTA in Europe is now HTA 2.0 Europe? Well, today we have expanded beyond the networks of HTA experts only. We embrace stakeholders, not only as the recipients of the HTA, finalized HTA information, but also those who we actively involve in the HTA production process. We moved beyond disseminating the ready-made HTA information in the form of HTA reports to each other. We share data to produce HTA information. We work together to produce HTA information. And we actually have developed tools for that, and we have built quite some trust in each other. And we also built on the changes that are happening in the external environment in which HTA operates, both upstream, with regulators and technology developers, and upstream, developing strategies and implementing them together with the decision makers. And in quite some instances, we also drive the change ourselves, not only respond to it. So the examples are numerous. And actually, this conference program is built so that both through the content and the format of the conference, we will live the 2.0 concept. We will interact with the purpose, action-oriented and results-oriented, with involving both HTA doers and users in this process, because we know there is a positive effect of such interaction. We will move from the vision and strategy that you will learn from the plenary opening through sharing the experiences and lessons learned in an evolving dialogue of the panel discussions of the first and the second day, and also presentations of the second day, knowing that we will work together in this process for developing the HTA in Europe to bring the greater value to the healthcare systems and ultimately to the European patient. So I would say we aim this conference to be a very important moment in our shared efforts to clarify the next steps in the process of implementing sustainable, permanent European cooperation for HTA. And we rely on you, and we encourage you to be active participants in this process.